I lied. I'm actually really excited about the mic, obviously. And, Swayze, my lizard, he was named for Patrick Swayze because he always dances. He's being, of course, as soon as I mention it, he's being kind of quiet right now. So, I'm gonna get a few, videos taken care of. And it's really fast to upload from my computer instead of like what I was doing before, which was recording with my phone and then transferring them to my computer and then uploading them onto my channel. So I could get the longer videos for you guys. The one that was about 56 minutes, it took me 4 hours to upload that one. And it took me 30 minutes to upload a 16-minute video. But when I do it on the computer, it doesn't take me that long. It's pretty awesome. For this video, I'm gonna do a whispering test because I know a lot of you guys find that relaxing. I actually very rarely find whispering to be relaxing. Thank you. stride the billy goat, dug his heels into its sides, and galloped off down the high road. Phew, what a pace they went at. "Here I come," shouted Hans Clodhopper, and he sang till the air rang with it. The brothers rode on in silence. They did not say a word to each other, for they had to store up every good idea which they wanted to produce later on, and their speeches had to be very carefully thought out. "Halloo," shouted
Thank you.
she was lying on a sofa, fast asleep. She was so very beautiful that the merchant's son was driven to kiss her. She woke up and was dreadfully frightened, but he said that he was the prophet of the Turks, and he'd flown down through the air to see her, and this pleased her very much. They sat side by side, and he told her stories about her eyes. He said they were like the most beautiful deep dark lakes in which her thoughts floated like mermaids. And then he told her about her forehead, that it was like a snow mountain, adorned with a series of pictures. And he told her all about the storks which bring beautiful little children up out of the rivers. No end of beautiful stories he told her, and then he asked her to marry him, and she at once said yes. "But you must come here on Saturday," she said, "when the king and the queen drink tea with me. They will be very proud when they hear I am to marry a prophet. But mind, you have a splendid story to tell them. My parents are very fond of stories. My mother likes them to be grand and very proper, but my father likes them to be merry, so that he can laugh at them. Well, a story will be my only wedding gift," he said, and then they separated, but the princess gave him a sword encrusted with gold. It was the kind of present he needed badly. He flew away and bought himself a new dressing gown and sat down in the wood to make up a new story. It had to be ready by Saturday, and it is not always so easy to make up a story. Listen to his story attentively. There was once a bundle of matches, and they were frightfully proud because of their high origin. Their family tree, that is to say, the great pine tree of which they were each a little splinter, had been the giant of the forest. The matches now lay on a shelf between a tinder box and an old iron pot, and they told the whole story of their youth to these two. Runs through it. "Yes, one feels that," said the water pail. person in the spirit.